Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making twice baked sweet potatoes. This recipe actually was sent to me by one of my viewers, and I'd like to give credit to oOShihTzuLoveOo. So that's her name, and she wanted me to try this recipe, and I think it's simply delicious, and I wanted to share it with the rest of you. And with it getting close to Thanksgiving, you might want to use this form of sweet potato instead of your normal sweet potatoes with the marshmallows on top or the pecans and brown sugar or whatever you do. What you need are some sweet potatoes to start with, and I've chosen the red variety. You can see from the cut on the end, these are kind of orangey red. So you could use any type of sweet potato that you want. The recipe actually calls for 6 of them, and since this is just for Rick and me today, I'm dividing that recipe by 3. So keep that in mind. Everything that I say is only 1/3 the amount that oOShihTzuLoveOo sent me and uses for her recipe. And I'm sure they're good if they're left over. You could just heat them up. But we had 2 on hand and thought that 2 would be fine for us. Now, I'm going to try to follow her recipe pretty much as she has stated it, except for the division by 3. But there might be a couple of things that I will do differently just for my own convenience. I'm going to use a dish like this instead of just putting them on the rack in the oven. I don't think she actually said, but she has the oven set at 375, so that's where we are here in the kitchen. And I'm going to use this pan because it will definitely hold my 2 scrubbed and dried sweet potatoes. But also, when I cut them down the center to do the twice baked part, you actually will be getting out the potato meat and mixing it with some really good stuff and putting it back in. So I'll need some extra room, so I wanted something big enough. And what I'm doing is putting a liner in here because I don't want a real mess that sticks. And with brown sugar and butter and things like that, it might get really messy. So if you just put a liner in of aluminum foil, that will take care of that problem. Now, I like to spray my regular potatoes or sweet potatoes before I bake them. I have done loaded baked potato, and I have actually done twice baked regular potato. So if you're more interested in the regular potato, you will find a twice baked potato in Betty's Kitchen. So I'm just going to spray lightly. That keeps the crust from getting too crispy, although you do want a fairly crispy crust when you're going to stuff a potato. So I'm just using canola oil spray, any vegetable spray, Pam or something like that will do. Now these are going to go into the oven for about 1 hour, and I'll squeeze them, and if they're soft, I'll know to get them out, and we'll go from there. Here are my baked sweet potatoes, and I just got them out of the oven, and it was almost 1 hour, like about 2 minutes. And my reason for bringing them out was I did test them. I used an old pot holder that I didn't mind getting messed up because it's a little greasy here, and I could see that it was soft. Maybe you can see that give a little bit, but that tells me that it's done inside. Likewise, this one, they're about the same size, and you do want to match them up. You'll notice this one has some places where I've taken off bad spots. I don't know if it was just getting old or if they were there from the beginning, but you'll want to take those off, but you'll want to be careful when you get these skins. You're going to be splitting these in half and then digging out the potatoes, the sweet potato meat, when it's cool enough, but you don't want to tear up the skins. So just be careful if you have taken off pieces there. So what I need to do is go away and let these cool down. And when they cool down enough that I can handle them, then that's when I want to remove the potato meat. And then I've got all of these things that you might see that I'm going to put in there. It's going to be a wonderful blend of flavors. And then I'll go back in the oven for a few minutes and we'll be done. Our sweet potatoes have cooled a little bit so that we can handle them. And you can see what I've done is take a knife and cut them in half like this one. And then I have used a spoon that is the right size to get in here. And I've gotten out as much as I can without disturbing the bottom and sides, because we want it to have a good container to put back in. So I've done three of them already. There's probably a little more here that could come out, because you want as much of that sweet potato meat as possible to mix in with your good flavors. And then the last one, I can show you, I want to get that clean, that you just dig in like this, and it's very soft because it's done. And I just sort of make a circle to get a good start there, and we're putting all the potato meat over to the side. That went way down to the bottom, so I'm going to back off of that just a little bit. You're always keeping in mind that you're trying to get as much out, but to leave the skin intact. And the skin is still there, even though it did take the meat down to the bottom. So there we go. And a little bit more here. So it doesn't take really very long for each one. So we'll call this one done, even though I think I probably could get a little bit more out of that, particularly along that side. But it's good eating like that anyway, so it doesn't matter if you leave a little bit extra in there. So you get your four half potatoes ready, and you notice the other side is nice and brown, but it's not burned or anything. This looks very dark in here. That's just a peculiarity of the sweet potato and its form. I'm going to take a little mixing bowl right here, and the first thing I'm going to put in is brown sugar, light brown sugar, and I've measured it out 1 1/3 tablespoons, and 1/3 of a tablespoon is a teaspoon. So you have 1 tablespoon and 1 teaspoon, and you want that firmly packed, so they go in like that. Next, you need some butter that is at room temperature. You need 1 1/3 tablespoons. And you have tablespoon markings on your sticks of butter in here. So just go 1 1/3 of the way to the next mark, and you have it. Remember, I'm giving you just 1/3 of the real recipe, because we're only doing the two potatoes. So you can multiply by 3, and the numbers look a little nicer. Here we have 1 1/3 ounces of cream cheese at room temperature. And this is the fat-free kind. If you don't like the fat-free, use the full-fat variety. And then the rest of this is just some spices and seasonings. We have cinnamon, and in dividing this recipe by 3, it's just a dash. I think I'll write up the recipe just as it was given to me by oOShihTzuLoveOo. And I will give you 3 times as much as what I'm putting in here, but I'm putting in just enough to do our 2 sweet potatoes. But just a little dash of cinnamon, more cinnamon than the others that are going to come up. So just a little bit there. And then the next one we have is nutmeg. So just give it a shake. Not quite as much as the cinnamon. And then we have ginger, and my shaker's gone on the top there, so I just put it in a little spoon here, but probably not all of it, because it shouldn't be too much either. About the same as nutmeg. And then we have salt, and I'm just going to salt as I would a couple of sweet potatoes. And then we have ground pepper, fresh ground peppercorns. So you're using the peppercorns, and you're actually grinding it in, and it just would be what you would normally maybe put on your potato, a regular potato or a sweet potato. And those are just really lovely flavors to try to blend together. So give me a minute here, and I'll come back with these all blended together, and I'll probably start filling those, and pretty soon we'll have them all filled. I finished mixing up that mixture of brown sugar and butter and cream cheese and all those spices. And this is what it looks like. So the next thing is it goes in these warm, almost hot, potatoes, sweet potatoes. So I'm just going to bring this out of the mixing bowl. And then I need to mix this up a little bit. Let me try to get all of this, all of that good flavor is right in there. Okay, once you get that, then probably a fork would be good. I just got out a spoon, so I'm gonna reach over here and get a fork and mash this up. And you'll notice that the sweet potato is very soft, so it's very easy for you to mash it up. You just want to get it all blended together really well so you can stuff it back into those potato halves. Doesn't that look good? I've just finished filling the last sweet potato skin, and I'm putting them back in the pan where they were cooked originally. And this goes back to a 375 degree oven, and it will take about 15 minutes for these to brown off, and then they'll be ready to eat. This is kind of mid-afternoon for Rick and me, but we'll probably have a little snack today. Here are our finished twice-baked sweet potatoes. They've been in the oven again for about 15 minutes, maybe a little more than that, and you can see what they look like. Actually, if you did the whole recipe, there would be 12 of these, because I only did a third as much as the recipe calls for, but I will write up the complete recipe. And you would put these out on a nice platter, but you could serve an individual serving like this. So I have it over here on a serving plate, and let me just show you the texture. When you dig in there, it's nice and steamy. It's very hot coming from the oven. And I always pick these things to taste of, but here goes. I want you to see my impression of what this tastes like. Oh, with that steam, I think I'll take a smaller bite. Yummy. Excellent. I love the recipe. Thank you, oOShihTzuLove. I'm glad you sent me this, and I picked it out of probably 100 that had been sent to me, and I said, that's going to be a good recipe. So thanks, and I hope I did it well for you in terms of the way you do it, and I hope all of you will consider using this just as a fall recipe or for a holiday meal, maybe Thanksgiving or Christmas. Hope you enjoy it.